Wow, welcome back to the Live Line TV and Radio. It's the homie Bank Ball Recibo. And I got the one and only, you know what I'm saying, Quan Flees in the building. What's happening with you,
Quan, bro?
Man, I appreciate you stopping by, pulling up, coming outside, you know what I'm saying? You told me you was coming through. You was way all over the world. You heard me? You was hitting me on the gram, you know what I'm saying?
I work, B.
It's like, man, I'm going to be back home. We got a link. It's like, all right. You was like, all right, 6 weeks. I'll be home in 2 weeks. And then you came home and was like, boom, we got it set up. Let's roll with it. But I appreciate you coming through. So we got the whole time to focus on you, you know what I'm saying? Talk about what you got going on, the things that got you involved in this industry, you know what I'm saying? All kind of conversation I won't have with you, bro, because you've been when I first met you, you was shining. I'm like, this guy right here, and I don't want to say I was looking at you funny. I wasn't. I was looking at you like, because you were standing out. And I just knew it was just something about you. I was like, something about this dude that says entertainer. You know what I'm saying? But I had to wait for long because you worked your way up to me. You were like, what's up, brother? You know what I'm saying? What's up, Blue Blue? Matter of fact, we was at the Razzle Dazzle pop-up shop. Shout out to Razzle Dazzle and Elgiz, you know what I'm saying?
Shout out Elgiz off top.
Yeah, we was over there. You was like, you didn't take long. You was boom. You was very social. You was speaking to everybody. You was engaging with everybody. That's how we met. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, we did the pop-up shop here. You know what I'm saying? You called. You were like, man, I'm coming through. And when you
that
came,
it was lit too.
Yeah, when you came, you brought a party with you though, man. You performed, you modeled, you know what I'm saying? You was doing your thing. Like, man, dog, you know, nigga Quan really like on his shit. He ain't missing. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't even really know, you know what I'm saying? But you showed me ASAP. So, you know, I was excited to do this interview because I knew it was so much about you, so many different layers, you know what I'm saying, to the people of New Orleans. It's time for them to understand who you are. Get to meet you, you know what I'm saying? And all the other platforms, y'all need to lay up there, put them on right after this, you know what I'm saying? Because we need y'all to talk to this brother, get down involved with this music, see what's happening, get behind him, Nola. So let's get off into it, Quan. You know what I'm saying? In fact, let's come up with how you came up with the name Quan Flees, you know what I'm saying? Tell us about that, brother.
So the way I came up with the name is my middle name is Quan. One day, you know, I just had on this nice little cashmere fleece, and I'm like, dang, it feel real nice on. And I'm like, Quan Fleece. Oh, yeah, I feel right in place, right nice on. So, you know, that's where it came up from. And from then on, I just been Quan Fleece.
So how old you was when that happened?
I was 29.
You was how old?
I was 29 when I came
20,
up.
29? Yeah. So that's when you started. When you started doing music, though? Quan?
I actually ventured into music last year in May. I never really had any musical background, schooling or anything, really.
That's amazing.
And I might have played flute and Eisenhower, but...
So we got to go back a little bit further. We got to go all the way back. Let's go all the way back. Let's go all the way back, all right, Quan? You from the West Bank, right? What part of West Bank you from?
Oh, man, I'm from Elgiz, man. You know, I'm
1.5,
over there.
Shout out, man, to the 1.5.
1.5, you're my over there in the cutoff, man. You know
all
what
right,
it is.
Right. Everybody down there in the cutoff, still down there doing their thing, you know what I'm saying? So, what school you went to?
Oh, man, I started off at Eisenhower. I was going there, and then I shout out to LB Landry. That was like the time of my life, you know, because... during those times, that school was like a place where, like, most kids would go only for trouble, you know what
uh-huh.
I mean? You know what I mean? Like,
so you used to get in trouble a lot?
Yeah.
Was you had to call it behavior disorder or attention disorder? What they label jazz?
Attention disorder. I just wanted more in life, you know? Uh-huh. So, like, in school, I didn't fit in. So, like, when I was asking a question, more teachers felt as though I'm challenging them. So, you know, it caused trouble because then I just thought, developing like thoughts, like, you know, people, you know, people start riding off school after a while. You know, at the Landry, I shot the car. Then, you know, Katrina happened, and after that, you know, I was in a lot of schools.
Oh yeah, so you definitely was in it. You was in it when Katrina happened. After Katrina, nobody was in school in New Orleans.
Nah, not at all. Not until October. In October, they let us come back.
All right then.
To Jefferson Parish, though.
In Jefferson Parish. Yeah. So, that's where you're born and raised, Algiers.
Born and raised. You know, born
and raised.
Where
your mama raised. From? Oh, your mama
from Algiers? Mama from Algiers, too. You heard me? So, at the day I was born in Charity.
Yeah, all right, Charity.
All of
Charity,
us.
Charity
all
baby,
down
huh?
Here. Yeah, Charity baby.
So, shout out to your people, man. Shout out to all
shout
your
Shout out Algiers, man. Shout out to West Bank. Shout out to Fisher. Man, I love y'all boys, man. You heard me? Joe, Mac, BB, Jonathan. You heard me? Joker B, all y'all boys. Spaz, everybody.
We here, man. So let me ask you another question about, you know, so you from here, you know, you went to school here, you know what I'm saying? What came first, you know what I'm saying? Was it because I see you modeling and you're traveling, you're doing a lot of that. So that had to come first, right? I mean, what was inspired you doing this modeling thing, right? Talk to us about that. Explain that. Tell me how this all working for you.
Okay, so the modeling thing actually came second. I was doing the music first.
Okay, all right.
The modeling thing actually stumbled in because of networking, you know, just being sociable, knowing good manners, talking to people with respect. Some people say you got to earn it, but I kind of give it until you lose it. So that showed people like, oh, he easy to talk to. You know, networking and just somebody giving me opportunity to showcase it.
Okay.
And I just, what I do all the time when I hit the stage, I perform, I execute.
So what type of, you showed me already, but you got to let the people know, like, talk to us a little bit about the places you've been modeling, you know what I'm saying? Because before we get back, I want to get back to the music, but I think the way you mix that in a little bit and how you still working that, you know what I'm saying? Let us know if you're still working it, but, you know, where you been at with this so far?
So right now, I Fashion Week model in L.A. I'm headed to New York in September. I'm going to be actually walking 3 runways out there. On the Model Experience Runway, Rise Week, and then I can't really think of the third one at the moment. The modeling is definitely something you would see me in for the rest of my career because I love clothing, I love the art. And I am also going to be in France here come in a September, October-ish. I'll be in Paris, you know. I'm going to walk Fashion
overseas,
Week out there.
Yeah,
so I'm going to be over there, you know. It's a hard work, you know. I actually, if I tell anybody who wants to do this, you prepare yourself. Learn to answer difficult questions. Learn the craft of walking and posing and how to hold it and how to work the runway to your favor. And learn to network. So, you know, network is always big.
Bet that. So, you pursued that, you went out and found an agency, or did the agency discover you, or did you know somebody who knew somebody, like, you know, what was your way in?
My way in was, like, I'm actually signed to Queen A Entertainment.
Okay.
Queen A Champions, IG, she manages me and everything.
Okay, that's your shout out to Queen A.
Yeah, Queen A Champion, all together.
Queen A Champion.
On IG, let me anything.
Queen A, shout out to Queen A Champion. Don't forget the champion.
Yeah,
dunking
I mean,
on him.
Yeah, I just started this on my own, just searching IG, mm-hmm. looking for realistic people. And Queen, she managed me. She makes sure all situations go in my favor as her artist.
That's what she's supposed to.
So, you know, before you want to get a manager, make sure you have something to manage. People don't understand that, but
yeah,
that's what you need. When you start venturing in these performances, that's what you need, a manager. And so I'm really in pursuit of this modeling career. I really want to be international with it. That's why I'm going overseas. I want to be a pioneer in a new phase.
So what genre would you consider your music at this moment? You know what I'm saying? Because when you said that, I was going to hold off on that question, but I think it kind of opened up the door for me to say that part.
alternative fusion.
Okay.
It's like a vibe. It's a vibe with a twist.
Your energy, bro, it be on that kick, though. Like, for real. Like, I got to come closer to you because, you know, you're like a magnet. You know what I'm saying? That's how you were when I first met you. I was like, man, dude got swag. Like, he got drip. You know what I'm saying? He got presence.
New Orleans drip, by the way. That so, New Orleans
you're
dripping, drip.
But you know, it ain't the same type of drip. I already, when you first told me you did music, I'm like, okay, I didn't know what to expect. But I was glad when I got what I got, because I'm like, that's your whole persona. You know what I'm saying? That alternative, that fusion. You know what I'm saying? You stepping outside of the box completely. You know what I'm saying? But I'm glad you're not afraid to really go there. You know what I'm saying? So what gave you that idea to go alternative and try different sounds versus going the normal route, rapping and stuff? Or was you rapping first, and how that went for you?
So I actually taught myself how to rap.
Uh-huh.
And I was watching these guys sing all these melodies, and I'm like, fusing all these guys. I'm like, man, look at all these people doing this. Maybe I could try.
Uh-huh.
So later I started with that May. I say about October I stopped playing with like my vocals and actually went to go record Remember Me, and mm-hmm. that's when it all started. The open Pandora box.
I think your style is real unique, the way you coming. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely Live Line material. You know, y'all gotta check out this Live Line radio thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's really popping. We got all of New Orleans,
check
all
this out.
Stuff.
Check
you
it
know
out,
what I'm
y'all.
Saying? Download it in your Google
Everybody
Play.
Everybody mess with me. Check
in
that out.
OTN. We got you in rotation. You know what I'm saying? We got the homie, the one, the only in the building, you know what I'm saying? And we got to make sure everybody understands that it don't always have to be this hip-hop, rap, gangster, ops. We going to murder you when we see you. We sliding on you. That's cool. You know what I'm saying? You know, I understand how the street level goes. So what's your preference? You know what I'm saying? The lane you in right now, you know, because you say you started rap. You can rap if you chose to, right? You know, so all the alternative, like, which one is the route you taking mostly?
I'm just taking the alternative because I feel as though I can touch people.
But you are. You catching a lot of bees with that honey.
Yeah,
right.
I just feel as though with the alternative, and not it's not really alternative. I don't know really call it because I smash so much together. I'm like Kobe. So I have my arsenal is like very, very. I got a big bag. So my music, I want to touch people, and I want to touch people emotionally through a rhythm, a melody. Like rap, you're going to touch people. You're going to have it turned up hype. But I want to put you somewhere where I know the pain is. You know?
Right.
I want to pull that pain.
It sound like it's you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
The way the music, the way the style is you. You can't fake that style. But the words are there. You know what I'm saying? So you writing that, you got a team of writers, or, you know, how you coming up with the lyrics for your music?
I write all my music.
Okay,
I write
all right.
It all.
Well, you know, it's no these days. Some people have a little, and I'm not saying you.
No, I do. But, I have a little. No, hey, nothing wrong with that. You feel
yeah,
me?
It's nothing wrong with having, you know, people that's in your corner,
you know,
helping
I
you
do,
with music.
I have somebody. Right now, I have my manager. Like I said, she hands on. So she's hands on with everything. She has did the lyrics, and she's also a creator. She's a writer too.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, she went to school for us, so she knows like what I need. So, you know, she listens and she makes sure before anything comes out, it has to be, you know, out there with the pop.
And I strongly encourage a lot of artists that's willing to, because see, when you rapping, okay, I get it, you're rapping, you know, but when you taking that route you taking, sometimes you need other ears, you know, and you almost all the time you're going to need other ears and other, you know, influences there to help you elevate. You know what I'm saying? When you taking the route you taking, you know. So I don't want to take up too much time because, you know, we got a lot of conversation to have. We're going to take us a quick music break. You know what I'm saying? Because I want to highlight the artists we had here last week with L.A. Zoe was in the building. You know what I'm saying? Gave us a great interview last week, you know. And with his song Red Light, I told him, brother, we got you. So we gave him the Live Line approved for this week. L.A. Zoe was here last week. Y'all go check out the videos on YouTube, the interviews. Everything is there on the Live Line on YouTube. We got Quan Flees in the building, the one and only. The man said he came up with the name because he was so fly, he couldn't help himself. It fit him like a fleece, you heard me? Custom made, you know what I'm saying? Telling me. So the homie had to come through and let us know what's happening with it. We gonna get off into your music right after we do this song, because we're going to talk a little bit more about your style, your flavor, how you come up with what you come up with. We're going to get to the music so we can take this interview home. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to let them know what's happening with the music. We got to get back with some more of this modeling conversation, too, because they may have some people that's out there that want to know more about getting involved in it. You know what I'm saying? You might be able to help them. So let's get off into this L.A. Zoo.
Better stay tuned.
We'll be right back. Stay tuned. Quan Flees in the building. West Bank, stand up. That shit. Hey, I tell you why they want some of that flavor. You heard me? They want some of that Algiers flavor. That's why. Wow, welcome back to the Live Line TV Radio. We was over here throwing videos for the talk. You heard me? Don't stop. It's the Live Line TV and Radio, powered by the NOTN app. Download that in y'all Google Play and Apple Store. Shout out to LA. You know what I'm saying? Zoe was in the building last week. We got Quan Flees in the building right now. I was just telling the whole NOLA, these two link up is straight hit. It's a straight hit. You know what I'm saying? That's a look, that's going straight to the top of the motherfucking Apple charts. Telling y'all, you heard me? Spotify, SoundCloud, all that got to have flavor. You know what I'm saying? These two boys got flavor, and I got them back to back. So let's get with it, big brother. We were talking about traveling with the modeling, you know what I'm saying? Getting off into this, big brother. So, like, tell me some of the adversity you faced out here on the road doing this modeling thing, being, you know, new to modeling and stuff like that. You know, what's some of the adversities you faced that you had to, what's some of the things you had to overcome? You know what I'm saying? You know, to make sure your modeling career successful.
Not having an agency.
Okay. Why you say that?
Because the agency is like a dispatch.
Mm-hmm.
They basically get you work.
All right.
They basically showcase you as their talent and get you modeling gigs. But I'm off of independence in a certain way, shape, and form. So, you know, I have my manager who manages everything. So, you know, if any people are ever looking to ever jump into like modeling, what you need to do is go to these showcases that they have all the time. You can look them up. And they are desire new talent all the day, all time. So look out for showcases. That's one way I started.
I was actually trying to just do this thing called the Live Girls, the Live Line Girls or whatever. Well, you know, it wasn't a modeling agency, but it was like a home for anybody who wanted to start a portfolio. You know, because we got all these lights, all these cameras and stuff like that. Listen, we want to do these events, you know. So what do you say to, like, local events? Do you think there's enough local events here in New Orleans that kind of, like, cater to that kind of stuff? Or is there a market for that kind of stuff here in New Orleans for inspiring models to come together and do things? What are you seeing in the NOLA market that you probably seeing in other places that's not here in the NOLA market?
You know, I don't really think there's a big market out here for, like, for say, you know, more towards that West Coast and Southern to, like, Miami way to L.A. Especially, like, there really isn't a lot of help towards modeling. Like, you guys do a good job with your with your pop-up show with the modeling event in it. And, like, that's good for, like a rising model people because he's building a portfolio, which you need. That's how you showcase your talent.
That's the whole reason for it, to kind of allow people to build that.
Yeah, you have a video. You have head cards, which is head shots from your neck up so people can see your face because most times that's what they want to look at. Depending on what type of commercial or runway they're looking at you in some way, whatever the gig is, because you need that. And then a body card. Just so they can get your body, and usually on a body card in the back should have measurements on it. So, you know, that's good that he's doing that because then it keeps you independent. It keeps you having the ability to actually go get these gigs by going to showcases and having these model portfolios already in state because they're basically put you on a gig as a freelancer, which you are. You get paid, so you know.
Absolutely. I think it's a must have in a lot of situations for the NOLA, because we got our own culture, you know.
We do.
So everything come from us, you know what I'm saying? If we not creating it, then we don't want nothing to do with it.
Yeah.
If it ain't New Orleans, we really don't want embrace it like that. So when it comes down to like people embracing you, what are some of the things that's been a challenge, you know what I'm saying? Has there been people that's been knocking you, blackballing you, trying to stop you from getting to the next level out there? You know, you ain't got to call no names or nothing like that, but give us a little something on what's happening with those things, you know what I'm saying? Who, somebody knocking you, trying to knock your hustle or whatever, when it come down to modeling? Because I know you got a few haters out there. I know a few people
brother from the hood been in some fly clothes walking down the runway. They think something wrong with you. They think you kind of sweet. So
from family, you just come up with that, you know what I'm saying? Just you, right
some,
now you got
some
spikes
fam,
in
some,
your
some
chain,
fa- so all
you know
this,
what I'm saying, you got bullets in your leather, you know what I'm saying, wrist bracelet, you know what I'm saying, with some bling mixed in with it, you know what I'm saying.
Where my vibes at?
I was cautious. I was like, I was just coming in, making sure none of the spikes were sticking up. I was like, I don't want to get stuck with nothing. Let me just go ahead on and lean in a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
This all came from me, you know. I don't fit. I stand out for my family. I just stand out. This is me adventuring and finding who I am and who I'm becoming. You know, I've been trapped in a phase where people don't like to like venture out like this. You have to look a certain way.
And right, especially in New Orleans, you know what I'm saying?
Of course, you know.
Everybody look the same, everybody.
Over there from the Fisher.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So you know how it is, especially when it was the white tees and reeds, you know what I'm saying, era. So, you know, everybody dressed alike. Everybody got the same type of approach to what they're trying to do. So that's why I said you were standing out. Your whole attire, you know what I'm saying? You feel it's funny. Now I get it. All your fleets that you had, you know, like you really was wearing fleets, you know what I'm saying? Like, and it was like, man, look at this dude right here, bro. You know what I'm saying? This dude got a lot of swag. We got to find out who he is. Now you're in here. So let's get down to this music. You know, you started recording when you was 29 years old. Was there anything that was before that, you know what I'm saying, that led you up to that point? Was you running with a certain group of people, you know what I'm saying? Was it a producer? Did you just wake up one morning and say, I can do that, I can rap?
I did record something when I was 29. Didn't release it. It was really, wasn't up to par, and I gave up. And then when I turned 30, I actually was like, I'm going to try this. And so I recorded a rap song, took it out to Dallas with DJ Alamo. He got me on the radio out there, you know, off the network. Won a trip to Atlanta off it, performed it, and I was like, I won't sing.
So you just switched it up. You just laid up there. It was like, you did the rap song. You remember how it went? You won't kick a little something from it? If you won't, you know what I'm saying, you can't remember, because it probably was so long ago. Like, you know, I don't know how long ago it was, but you know, you know, there was so many recording sessions after that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so.
And since you switched over, you're probably not even rapping. You haven't have you rapped ever since that moment?
Playing around. I'm only staying in my lane.
So you never really recorded nothing that was rap wise?
Yeah, I got some recorded rap stuff that I haven't put out.
Okay, so we on to the new style, you know what I'm saying? You feel me? Soulja Safe Stay, first thing, get, you know, be original. You got your own style, niggas figure more. So you found your own lane. You say, all right. So how did you come to that conclusion? What made you say you didn't want rap no more? Something had to happen, Quan. Like, what happened? Like, you just, how you knew you can sing?
I think I started rapping when I listened to my song and I felt like I was just killing everybody.
That's complete confidence.
And so I was like,
oh yeah,
I was like,
take a drink to that one.
I was like, I was like, man, maybe I could try some. And then I was like, I told you I would never leave. I was like, oh yeah, I could do this. I could do this. Then, you know, the confidence grew also by my surrounding, who I put around me. You know, one thing I do is keep positive people around me. So they allow me to go into this phase with confidence, because, you know, sometimes in this phase and its appearance in my city, it's not accepted. But, you know, shit, I gotta do what I gotta do, what I feel.
Yeah, you
like.
Got that Martian swag. I'm not the same. Me from a whole nother planet type swag.
Hey, shout out to
it's dripping though. It's, and you getting and it works for you. Everybody ain't able to, you know, pull that swag off. You know what I'm saying? So was it around the time, you know, who was one of your inspirations that kind of had that, you know, alternative style out there? Because, you know, we had the death of Triple X Test. How you say his name? Triple X Testosterone, you know, he had that flavor going with him where he was just being original, not afraid to sing, carrying vocals that normal artists wouldn't carry, and just telling his truth, you know what I'm saying, how he felt. Were artists like him an inspiration, or did you hear that style and say to yourself, let me try it and let me see? I'm not in comparison, but that's sort of like the genre of music that you create in the essence, you know what I'm saying? To me, anyway.
Of course, all those guys before me, I kind of look at some of their stuff. I'm always going to go towards what I like, mostly what I like. But I'm going to be curious and see what others are wearing and see how they're wearing and see how confident it is. Mm-hmm. Because it's not what they're wearing that I'm looking for. It's their confidence in apparel. Because I'm like, okay, if they could be confident wearing what they want to wear, I could do it. Because they're in my same lane.
Absolutely.
So it makes me feel as though, okay, because we all dress out different ways. None of them is having no shout out Astros.
Shout out to the Astros. Yeah, you so got nobody, the Astro nobody jersey rocking on.
Like we might
right.
have the
I mean,
same type
if you didn't have like, those, if you didn't have those tights on underneath your jeans right now, we got to snap it up and for the gram, you know, you would need them tights on under your jeans. You got too many cuts in them.
So it's like our swag is so different. So, but at the same time, we all watching each other.
Yeah, hey, brother, I'm not ashamed to say it. You're putting it together. You know what I'm saying? I see your gram. I see how you're working. I see the things you was wearing on the runway with the jeans and the
fur mink.
Yeah, the fur mink. You know what I'm saying? Like, I couldn't pull it off. You know what I'm saying? I would probably have to go a little bit, me personally, a little bit, you know, casual. You know what I'm saying? I'm good in with the linen. You know what I'm saying? You put me in some linen, I kill it like on.
I don't know, big buddy. You might have ran. You might have walked it. You might have walked
it. But
you.
I don't know how to put it together. Only thing I know how to put together is really linen. You know what I'm saying? And jumpsuits. Other than that, I really can't put it together, like, you know, and I can, you know, if I really, really wanted to focus on it, but I know the look, you know what I'm saying, when I see it, like, some people put things together effortlessly.
I have a team. Like I said, my manager's always hands-on.
So you got help with that as well.
Yeah, so my manager is very hands-on, so even in my appearance, like everything.
Yes,
everything.
You know
everything.
What I'm
yeah,
you know what I'm saying.
You know,
saying.
I want to shout out the team. So I'm not doing this on my own. You know
dripping,
what I mean? I might be
y'all
out here in front y'all, but I got the team. You know what I mean? So like we winning. You know
if
me?
I had on this Astro jersey, I could not figure out a way to wear those jeans. You figured out a way by putting on tights underneath them. I would have never thought of that. I've been around here half all my legs. I like I don't feel right wearing this when all I had to do was put on tights underneath it. You know what I'm saying? I would have never thought of that. Like, y'all thought of that. You know what I'm saying? So now you able to kind of rock those jeans the way you rock them. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, the jewelry. I'm bad at jewelry selection. As you notice, I don't have any. All the thing I was good at doing was earrings. I can get a bad pair of earrings. You know what I'm saying? Like, yeah.
Well, yeah. The
you know, I can roll with some earrings. But outside of that, maybe a ring. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just horrible. I'm going to need to talk to your team. Tell them I got a little bit of budget, how much time they got to work with me. So tell us about your single that you put out. What was the inspiration behind it? And who was the producer? And how did you come up with the concept of the song that we getting ready to play?
So Remember Me is actually me having fun with my addiction while I'm going through misery. In the city that I'm from, New Orleans, every day is miserable, you hear me? But you know what we do? We live in a party. We party every day. Every day we wake up, we party to sun up to sundown, even if it's hard work. It's just the culture down here. So I embody the culture into the song, let you know, you know, dope boys, killers, I pass in the swamp sticks that I stay. I stay in the swamp sticks out here in New Orleans, you hear me?
And, ooh, I like that.
And most times all you passing is dope boys and killers. Like, because at the end of the day, everybody else in school, so that's the only people left out there walking around by you. So, you know, I put all that together and the concept just start running with the city and my emotion of the hurt and pain that I've been through. And right. At the same time, enjoying in my addiction. You know, everybody cope or deal with their mental defect in their own way. And that's how I dealt with it when I was going through these hardships. And at the same time, these rises, because I'm not going to say I was just falling. I was up and down just enjoying my ride in this place I call New Orleans.
So the brand new single Remember Me by Quan Flees, which is all him, as he just explained to y'all, you know what I'm saying? This is all him. It's about his journey, and it says Remember Me, you're dead. So we're going to get to this music video. I think it's one of the best shot videos of the year. You know what I'm saying? Let's check this out. We'll get right back to it. It's the Live Line TV and Radio, the homie Bang Boy Recite. We got Quan Flees in the building. We'll be right back, you dig?
Has anyone seen the Hollywood Pompeii guy?
Told you I would never leave. I told you I would never leave. Those boys, killers, I pass. The swamp sticks where I stay. You know, I never really known. Use all my resource. You was my resource. Wishing for those dinosaurs. I know you play your part. Yeah. I know you play your part. Yeah. Taking pills on the school bus. Yeah, yeah. I know it's two of us. Yeah, yeah. My nigga died for being real. That's why real always get you killed. I told you I would never leave. Those boys, killers, I pass. The swamp sticks where I stay. I know you always wishing I was gone. I know you always wanna be alone. I had to do it on my own. Big pot of tea, big weed, that was me. Still a little G, but I still flood the streets. I was the one that made sure the dogs eat dogs, yeah, the dogs eat. I told you I would never leave. Those boys, killers, I pass. The swamp sticks where I stay. Blue pills that I take. My face that I can't feel. I pop a lot of pills. I feel what I can't feel.
Wine. Welcome back to the Live Line TV and Radio. It's the Omen Bank Bar Recite. Our Queen Tiara C is out on assignment. We got Quan Flees in the building. Y'all make sure y'all download that NOTN app in Google Play and Apple Store if you want to hear that song you just heard on a Live Line radio being featured in the NOTN app. You know what I'm saying? 24/7, we are the pulse of New Orleans music. You feel me? We got that right there. Remember by Quan Flees in regular rotation. So download us and you can hear that song. Take it wherever you go. Brother, that's a hit. That's a banger. You did that. You did that. You know what I'm saying? Was that just a single or EP or something like that? Was that an EP or just a single?
That was just a single.
That was just a single. You know what I'm saying? So, what other singles can we expect from off your? What's your go to? Apple, Spotify. What's your favorite streaming platform?
All of them.
All of them, because they all kind of hold your music, right?
They all hold my music. I love.
So we use Apple right here. Something we do.
I got a song that's gonna be dropping soon. I'm headlining Summer Culture Fest in Miami, July 22nd. All y'all should show up 2 p.m. Come run down there, vibe out with all my vibes.
Absolutely. And tell them your Instagram. What's your Instagram page?
My Instagram is Quan Flees. That's QuanFlees. Double E S.
They're gonna see you as Quan Flees on
everything.
On everything.
Everything.
F L E E S. Flees, you dig? We all know how to spell Quan. You don't know how to spell Quan, you need to go back to school.
Hey, but another thing, and I will be performing my new single hit that's coming out, Gucci on My Eyes. That's releasing from an EP that's going to be coming out later.
We called got an EP.
That's going to be coming out later. I can't tell y'all when.
So y'all, all right. So y'all ain't going to, all right. I feel you because sometimes you got to lay up there, organize it before you start throwing out the dates and all that. So what can we expect from that project, you know, Mr. Flees? I'm sure... You right now you're just dripping in confidence. You know what I'm saying? Everywhere you're going is, you know, you're confident. You know, I'm sure you had a fun weekend this weekend out
there. It's all God. That's why I'm dripping.
You did anything this weekend, or was you chilling with the fam, or did you go out there this weekend? Did you enjoy yourself, or did you stay away from it?
We cut up. You know, right, I bought Buku fireworks. So, you know, we popped on the yard. You know, we have big property to do something like that, you know?
All right. Quan Flees in the building, you know what I'm saying? Letting us know how it's going down, you know? So, Quan, say, brother, what can we expect? Is there any people you want to give a shout out? Any features that we can expect?
Yeah, I want to shout out my video guy for Remember Me, Hollywood Pompey. Shout him out. You heard me, my guy. Shout out Queen A Entertainment, Queen A Champion. Shout out. You know, the team, you know, I just appreciate all y'all, you hear me?
Tell me, is there any artist in the city any artist that you prefer to work with? If you had to pick a couple of artists, one artist, anybody you could think off on the top of your head?
I thought you just had one.
You know, who was it though?
I guess the artist that just came in, huh?
You know what I'm saying? Wait, yeah, that's okay. All right, L.A. Zoe. You know LA. What I'm saying? You won't work. I know we.
LA, I won't work.
You won't work with LA Zoo.
We're going to holler at you. We're going to try to do something.
I told y'all on the gram just now, if they do a song, Quan Flees and LA Zoo, I'm going to film the video. Yeah, we could go wherever y'all want to go in the 504, of course. Anywhere y'all want to go in the 504, we could do as many scenes. We don't need the whole hood coming out. We just need to get it in, get it in, and get out so we can get the editing room and make sure we get this thing out there ASAP. But if y'all two do a song, I don't care what level it's on. I know what level it's going to be on, though.
Top notch.
You know, I do the video. You know what I'm saying? I do the video. I film the video. I do it just so we can get it out there. Whatever channel y'all want to put it on YouTube, y'all can put it on whatever channel y'all want to put it on.
LA, hit me up, man.
You heard me. Like that. Just to see that happen.
Shoot it.
So that's incentive there. Just to see that work. Just to see that pop. You know what I'm saying? But if there was an old school artist, you know what I'm saying, from a any era of music, of, you know, of a genre of music in New Orleans that you can just say, hey, I want you to feature on this album, who would that be?
Man, you know it's gonna be Wayne.
See, that's a man that knows music. You know that's a man. Hey, I don't knock. See, people be hating on Wayne, son. Not want to give Wayne the accolades he deserves in 25 years.
I can imagine with my type of voice, he gonna rap around it. He gonna go crazy.
Weezy F baby, come on
the
now.
Tootsie, holler at me, baby.
Might need you to endorse that song. Him and Ali Zoo gonna do. You know what I'm saying? You know, we might need you to endorse that, Weezy. You feel me? So, of course it'll be Wayne. You know, and I don't blame you for saying that because Wayne to me is the greatest rapper to ever live. And I don't want to. People want to argue about that. It's fine with me. And anybody who you put up against Wayne probably have already admitted Wayne was better than him. Or they did. So, at the end of the day, you know, who you going to put up against him? Jay-Z? And Jay-Z done already called him, you know what I'm saying? And said, you know, he gave Wayne his flowers, you know what I'm saying? So,
man, Wayne that guy.
He that guy. He definitely is that guy. So,
why you think he, at this point in his career that he at, and people still asking him for features? Think about it.
When you look into it, when you dive into it, he is what hip-hop is. There was a narrative. You know that movement went down, hip-hop dead. You know what I'm saying? And Wayne saved it. When everybody else was not, you know, living up to the hype or taking breaks, Wayne was out there working, you know what I'm saying? For that little five-year stretch, he was working and saved hip-hop. And a lot of people was able to transition over and a new era eventually came in, but Wayne held that gap down until the new generation came in. You know what I'm saying? And some people, matter of fact, let me get your opinion on that. You know what I'm saying? Speak, you are part of the new generation of music, you know what I'm saying, with the movement and stuff like that. What's your opinion, you know what I'm saying, on a new generation of music when it comes to like comparison of the is it worth saying old school